What's going on, guys, and welcome back here to another video, my friends. We got ourselves a heck of a weather update for you guys regarding Thanksgiving's overall forecast. We're going to be going over current conditions, the models, what you can expect, how much snow could happen, as well as where could see the snow, and everything like that. But I want to go ahead and say, guys, happy Thanksgiving to y'all. I know it's not Thanksgiving quite yet, but happy early Thanksgiving. I hope you guys have a wonderful, wonderful Thanksgiving, y'all. Well, without further ado, let's go ahead and jump on into it. So first thing we're going to take a look at it here is the satellite imagery. Currently, you can notice there's a lot of moisture working its way over the Rocky Mountains currently, driving a bit of snowfall for those upper elevations. We turn off the satellite and just overlay the radar here. You can see we do have a bit of heavy snow ponding up in like western areas of Colorado, portions of Utah, you know, even Nevada, California, still seeing a lot of snow. Dude, they've been absolutely been getting pounded by a lot of snow for the last several days out here across California, as we've had that atmospheric river, just that big conveyor belt of moisture rolling through. So this is really the early signs of this storm really starting to come together. Now, tomorrow is going to be a very important day because all of this moisture, as it rolls its way off into the central U.S., we're going to start to get a low that develops, a low-pressure system. We'll look at the models here in a minute, and that will allow basically for the possibility, or I should really say that will allow for the storm to kind of organize itself and, you know, really get itself going here for tomorrow. So, so that's current view of the satellite and radar. Just wanted to go ahead and pull it up real quickly. We also do have a little bit of a system kind of tapering off here in the northeast, you know, just a little bit of snow, a little bit of rain mixture going on currently. But a lot of the other part of the country is relatively quiet. So let's go ahead and hop on over here to the models, my friends, starting off here with the American GFS run. So the latest GFS here regarding this system, as you can see, that low starts to basically develop here for the kind of morning, afternoon, tomorrow across the central and southern plains. This is basically like the engine of the storm, you know, getting everything kind of together, everything working up together. So what's going to end up happening here is the moisture is going to start to come into the system from the Gulf of Mexico. We're going to start to get a lot of that moisture advecting northbound, which will, you know, kind of allow for the storm to pick up even more moisture. So right now you can see all of the moisture, all the snow is over the Rocky Mountains. We work our way down in time here, and then we're going to start to see more moisture be added to the system here from the Gulf of Mexico, you know, including a bit of warm air towards the southern side. Now, there's actually going to be a risk for severe weather as well. We'll get into that here more in a few minutes, but there is going to be a risk out there for severe weather, not only tomorrow, but for Thanksgiving too. So it's really 2 days worth of severe weather. We'll get into that here in a minute. So according to the GFS here, you know, we could start to see early bits of snow falling for the late 27th, you know, kind of around the evening time for tomorrow. We could start to see maybe a little bit of snow out there by like Illinois, Indiana, out there towards like Ohio. But really, it's going to really start to kick up here once we approach our way into the early portion here of Thanksgiving. A lot of the snow is going to be falling for, you know, the folks out there in the Ohio Valley. I mean, Ohio, you know, Indiana, portions of like Pennsylvania could be getting a little bit of snowfall. But if they do, it's going to be early. It's going to be before you honestly probably wake up. So you might wake up to a little bit of snowfall. We'll get into the overall totals and stuff like that. Honestly, these areas are probably not going to see too much. Now, areas up in the northeast, that's a bit of a different story. We also do have ourselves a lake effect problem that's starting to arise towards the Great Lakes region, which we'll get into that here more in a few minutes as well. So we work our way further down in time, kind of for more of the afternoon, late morning, early afternoon here for Thanksgiving, and the snow should be roughly up there by like New York State, starting to dig its way into the interior portion of New England. Now, the coastal areas here, we're going to do a quick little zoom real quick. So those coastal areas here overall are probably going to just see a bit of rainfall because, you know, the water out here, the ocean, keeps the coast a little bit warmer. So these areas, you know, including like New York City, you know, Boston, Massachusetts, you guys are probably just going to be dealing with a bit of rain here for tomorrow, or sorry, Thanksgiving afternoon here for the 28th overall. And then, of course, we work our way further down in time here, basically for the early portion of the 29th. And that's kind of whenever everything really starts to go away. So the storm itself should be out of the country here, you know, basically the late 28th, late Thanksgiving into early 29th overall. Now, at this point, this is where kind of that lake effect snow threat kind of arises, because basically what we're going to be having here is a lot of that really sharp cold air coming down from Canada, coming down from up north, and that's going to be rubbing over those Great Lakes that are still relatively warm, which will allow for the condensing to occur and basically for the ponding of several potential feet of snow to fall across some of these areas. Now, the snow totals, you know, regarding these, you know, lake effect overall is still unknown, but there really could be a lot of snow, as we could be seeing snow for multiple days as that cold air rolls its way over the Great Lakes there overall. So that is definitely something that I wanted to show you guys as well. Now let's go ahead and take a look here at the Euro. We'll get into the snow accumulations and stuff like that here in a minute. So the European model here regarding everything, you know, we're just taking a look at other models just to kind of see where they stand with one another. So really the same thing happens. I mean, according to Euro, there might even be a little bit of snow out there by, like, you know, like Kansas maybe. GFS really didn't pick up on that, but this is here for tomorrow afternoon, going into tomorrow evening. That low kicks off across the central southern plains, works its way up here to the northeast. We start to get ourselves a bit of, you know, heavy rainfall in some spots out there by like Missouri, Illinois, Kentucky, basically for the late 27th, and then going into basically early Thanksgiving here. Now, there could be a little bit of severe weather, like we mentioned here, for late tomorrow into Thanksgiving across the southeast. We'll break that more down here in a few minutes. But so there could be a bit of storm activity here. You can see Euro starting to pick up on that. A little bit of storm activity rolling through. And kind of the early signs of some winter weather starting to happen for the really early portion of Thanksgiving. I mean, we're talking like past midnight, probably starting to see quite a bit of snow starting to develop out there, kind of a wintry mix as well, potentially. Now, Ohio, you guys out here, honestly, I'm not really expecting you guys to get a whole lot of snowfall, as we're getting ready to see here in a few minutes, too. But it's really the northeast here, in portions of like the upper side of the mid-Atlantic, that could see a bit of snowfall here in general. So then, of course, we work our way into the afternoon, kind of, you know, eventually rolling in right to the evening here for Thanksgiving. That snow really does kick up. Now, Euro actually has the system being much stronger than what the GFS suggested, showing that low actually getting down into the 980s, kind of as a nor'easter, a pretty strong, you know, coastal snowstorm here, which, you know, once again, those coastal areas, like we mentioned on the GFS, it's going to be relatively just too warm, and honestly, we're not going to really be seeing any winter precipitation out there overall. It's just going to be too warm for that. The interior portions of New England, though, where it's a bit cooler, will be more of a likelihood for some heavy snow. But yeah, Euro honestly looks pretty strong. And you can also see that lake effect following after, once again, as that cold air does push its way through. So that's the GFS we looked at earlier. This was just the Euro we looked at. So we're going to look at one more model. This is the Canadian model, and then we'll look at the accumulations and stuff like that, and then we'll talk severe weather and everything. So according to the GDPS, which is the Canadian model here, you know, we start to get that low developing once again here for tomorrow afternoon. You know, that's relatively similar. There's not any snow for Kansas. Two out of three models we looked at doesn't really show that. I wouldn't get your hopes up. Even if we did, it would be probably in terms of flurries and nothing really too significant. But as we approach our way into the early part of Thanksgiving, we do start to get quite a bit of rainfall out there towards the Tennessee and Ohio Valley, eventually turning into snow kind of for the later morning, kind of mid-later morning there for Thanksgiving Day. I feel like the GDPS is a little bit ahead of schedule compared to some of those other models here. And then, of course, we work our way into the afternoon, and by the time we approach the afternoon, we'll be getting that snow out there kind of towards the interior portion of New England. Once again, those coastal areas still going to be just too warm. I'm not expecting really any snow for you guys. Probably just going to be rain out there by coastal New England, including New York City, including areas like I said, Boston, Massachusetts, and some of those areas there overall. Just going to be too warm for all of that and all that. So, but there will be some snow for the Northeast here. So that's kind of the timing in general. You know, it seems like all the models are roughly on schedule regarding the timing. It looks like that snow is going to start to happen early Thanksgiving morning there before sunrise out there towards the Ohio Valley. As the sun comes up, the snow will be kind of pushing out of Ohio in towards areas like Pennsylvania. Then, of course, we work our way into the evening. And by that point, the snow will be up there towards more like, you know, New York State, Vermont, New Hampshire portions, maybe towards western Massachusetts. We'll have to see if it gets cold enough for that. Then eventually exiting off Maine for the late part of Thanksgiving into the early portion here of the day after. So we're going to hop our way over here to the overall expected snowfall and stuff like that. So this is based off of the 50th percentile. This is basically the expected amount per National Weather Service. So this is how much we are expecting here over the next 72 hours. So the time I'm recording this is 3:25 p.m. Eastern time on the 26th. This is taking into consideration the next 3 days worth of snowfall. So as I mentioned out there by Lake Ohio, we're really not going to be dealing with a lot out here, honestly. It's going to be relatively low end. I mean, you'd be lucky if you pull an inch out there in Ohio. Now, areas up in like northeast Ohio towards Cleveland, you guys actually probably could pick up a couple of inches. We're going to start to see that lake effect becoming an issue in which you guys out there along the eastern side, of the Great Lakes of Lake Erie here for like northeastern Ohio, northwestern Pennsylvania, like western New York State. This is only for the next 3 days. There's going to be more lake effect snow pushing after that, in which, you know, some areas could easily break over a foot. I think a lot of these areas need to really be paying attention regarding the potential lake effect. So same thing for like areas in western Michigan too. I mean, overall throughout the next 3 days, majority of you guys in the southwestern side could pick up, you know, a possible 2 to 4 inches overall of snowfall. For areas up there towards like the northwestern and northern side of Michigan, we could have some locally higher amounts, but, you know, typically right around 3 to 5 inches towards the northern side. Once again, locally higher amounts will be possible. So then we dive our way up here into basically the portions of the upper portions of the Northeast here. Vermont, New Hampshire, you know, we're going to be roughly about 3 to 5 inches out here as well. Locally higher amounts over the next 3 days here. This is just, you know, overall snow for the next 3 days. And then, of course, we end off here with Maine, seeing possibly a good like 3 to 6 inches, maybe a little bit higher in some spots. You can see, you know, in some of those upper elevations could be a little bit higher where the air is a bit more cooler and all kinds of stuff like that. Now, the temperatures here regarding the time of Thanksgiving honestly is expected to be relatively above freezing. While there could definitely be some impacts, you know, regarding, you know, travel and everything like that for Thanksgiving, I think it's just going to be relatively too warm for it to really stick. I mean, the roads are still pretty warm at this point. We're going to hop back to the models here. So this is basically going our way into Thanksgiving. This is for the morning here of Thanksgiving. And you can see these temperatures across the Northeast and the Ohio Valley are just going to be slightly above freezing. Now, there will be some pockets here and there where we could be seeing, you know, at the freezing point or slightly below, which can allow for some, you know, roads to become a little bit iffy, especially bridges, because, you know, bridges, they have the wind flowing under and over them, which allows them to cool off much quicker than, say, you know, normal roads, because the ground does stay pretty warm for a longer period of time. But yeah, so it's just going to be a little bit too warm. Now, the night of Thanksgiving into the early morning of the 29th, I mean, we're going to be getting pretty cold here. That's another thing we do need to look at here as well. We'll go and hop back to the nation view here. We're going to be getting a heck of a lot of cold air working its way down into the country here. This is basically for the morning of the 28th here. This is for, you know, Thanksgiving morning here. And you could see, I mean, we're going to be up here in the upper Midwest. This is according to GDPS, by the way. I should mention that again. We're still in the GDPS. Showing possibly in the teens. I mean, up there towards, you know, the northern plains, possibly in the single digits. Let's hop over here to the GFS regarding the temperatures and stuff like that. Kind of want to get that opinion here. And actually, according to the GFS as well, maybe slightly a little bit warmer, more in the 20s and so forth, but still in the single digits up there towards the northern plains overall. You can see that cold front that's rolling through, that really sharp gradient. It's going to be temporarily warm in the southeast until that cold front rolls through, and then those cold air, then all that cold air is going to work its way down. But look at this. So as we approach our way into the morning of the 30th here, those temperatures are going to be getting into the negatives, possibly the negative 10s. Some areas could get even into the negative 20s, according to some of the models that I was actually paying attention to earlier. It could be certainly possible. We are going to see a lot of cold air work its way down here, according to the GFS and stuff like that, for the morning of the 30th. I mean, even the Ohio Valley could be getting into the teens and maybe the lower 20s overall, with the Northeast still kind of being in the 20s here in general. Mid-Atlantic, same thing. And even the Southeast here, you know, getting down into the 30s, you know, towards some of those coastlines there, could be definitely pretty cold. So that's something I definitely wanted to talk about that with y'all. But the last thing I do want to go ahead and mention here is also the possibility for severe weather, as we do have ourselves a severe weather threat here overall. For today, we are not expecting any severe weather because all that activity is over here. But once that low develops and we start drawing moisture from the Gulf and stuff, that's when we're going to have a little bit of a severe weather concern. So taking a look here at tomorrow's overall risk, areas out there by, you know, like northeastern Louisiana, places out there by like central Mississippi, central northern Alabama, you guys will be at risk here for possible severe weather. Now, there will be a small chance for some tornadoes across the region here. There's a 2% chance, which is a pretty low overall chance for tornadoes. I really wouldn't worry about it too much, but I would still watch the weather, as there could be a couple of isolated tornadoes nearby. It's the lower end threat for tornadoes, though, so there's no reason to, you know, full-on freak out or anything like that. It's pretty low odds, but still, keep an eye on it if you can. Now, there will be a shot for hail. This is a 5% chance for hail. We'll use Jackson as an example. So within 25-mile radius of Jackson, there is a 5% chance we could be getting hail, possibly quarter size, maybe slightly a little bit larger. And then lastly, we also do have a wind damage concern, possibility of some gusty winds up to right around 60 miles an hour or so. So it is a triple threat for tomorrow. It's just a low-end marginal level 1 severe weather threat. Now we work our way into Thanksgiving. Now, Thanksgiving's threat's actually pretty big. We do not have a tornado breakdown or hail or damaging winds quite yet, but look how big the marginal risk is here for Thanksgiving. I mean, seriously, stretching all the way from the central side here of Louisiana, going all the way up towards North Carolina for the possibility of severe weather. So areas out there towards, you know, eastern portions of Louisiana, central southern Mississippi, central and southern Alabama, the panhandle in the northern side of Florida, most of Georgia, all of South Carolina, and central and eastern portions here of North Carolina could be at risk for a couple of strong and possibly severe storms overall. So we'll have to continue monitoring that, and we'll keep you guys posted. But alrighty, everybody, well, that's going to go ahead and wrap up this video. If you guys did like this video, go ahead and leave a like and let us know in the comments what you guys thought of it. If you haven't already, guys, hit that subscribe button. We're on the way to working, we're working our way to 30,000 subscribers by the end of the year, which is just absolutely crazy. I'm very thankful. Thank you guys very, very much. If y'all do want to support what we do have those, you know, donation spots. You don't have to, of course, but if you would like to support what we do and help us invest into us, it would be greatly appreciated. And alrighty, everybody. Well, once again, thank you so much for being here. I really appreciate y'all. And alrighty, everybody. Thanks for joining. We'll catch y'all in the next one. Peace out, my friends. See you later on.